Hello students, welcome back to science class. In today's class, we will discuss about fiber to fabric. Dear students, what word comes to your mind when you hear the word fabrics? Yes, different color sarees, textiles, shop, shirts, clothes, etc. Fabric is another word for cloth. Different types of clothes are called fabrics. What type of clothes should we wear in summer? Yes, cotton. Because we sweat a lot in summers. Cotton is a good absorber of water. Which type of clothes we wear in winter season? In winter, we prefer to wear coat, jackets, hats, gloves, etc. Most of these dresses made from woolen. And these are all woolen dresses because to keep ourselves warm. In occasion, we would like to wear silk dress because it looks grand and beautiful. Okay students, cotton, silk, woolen, all these are called fabrics. Variety in fabrics. Some activities I have given in your textbook. First activity. With the help of a tailor or parent, collect a few pieces of different types of fabrics. Try to find out the names of the fabric and make notes on how they feel and what they are used for. Activity 2. Select a piece of cotton fabric you labeled in activity 1. Now try to find a loose thread or yarn at one of the edges and pull it out. When you pull the yarn or loose thread apart, you can see thinner strands. So this is a thinner strand, like this structure. These thinner strands are called fibers. Activity 3. Take out a yarn from a piece of cotton fabric. Place this piece of yarn on the table. Now press one end of the yarn with your thumb. Scratch the other end of the yarn along its length with your nail. Thin strands of thread are made up of still thinner strands are called fibers. Sometimes when you try to thread a needle, you find that the end of the thread has thin strands. Look at here. You can see here some thin strands. This makes it difficult to pass the thread through the eye of the needle. The thin strands that we see are called fibers. So, by doing these activities, we find that a fabric is made of yarns arranged together. Yarn is made up of fibers. So, fabric is made of yarns and yarn is made of fibers. On the basis of sources, fibers are classified into two categories, natural fibers and synthetic fibers. What is natural fibers? Natural fibers, which is obtained from plants and animals. Cotton and jute are examples of fibers obtained from plants. Silk and wool fibers are obtained from animals. Wool is obtained from the fleece of sheep or goat. It is also obtained from the hair of rabbits, yaks, and camels. Silk fiber is drawn from the cocoon of a silkworm. Synthetic fibers. For thousands of years, natural fibers were the only ones available for making fabrics. In the last 100 years or so, fibers are also made from chemical substances, which are not obtained from plants or animal sources. These are called synthetic fibers. Examples are polyester, nylon, acrylic. Some plant fibers. Have you ever made wicks for oil lamps? What do you use for making these wicks? Yes, cotton wool is also used for filling mattresses or pillows. Take some cotton wool and pull it apart and look at its edges. What you observe? The small, thin strands that you see are made of cotton fibers. Where does this cotton wool come from? It grows in the field. Cotton plants are usually grown at places having black soil and warm climate. Can you name some states of our country where cotton is grown? The fruits of the cotton plants or cotton balls are about the size of lemon. After maturing, the balls burst open and the seeds covered with them cotton fibers can be seen. Have you ever seen a cotton field that is ready for picking? It looks like, look at here, it looks like a field covered with the snow. From these balls, cotton is usually picked by hand. Fibers are then separated from the seeds by combing. This process is called ginning of cotton. Ginning of cotton means fibers are separated from the seeds by combing. So that process is called ginning of cotton. Ginning was traditionally done by hand. These days, machines are also used for ginning. One more plant sources is jute. Jute fiber is obtained from the stem of the jute plant. It is cultivated during the rainy season. In India, jute is mainly grown in West Bengal, Bihar, and Assam. The jute plant is normally harvested when it is at flowering stage. The stems of the harvested plants are immersed in water for a few days. The stems rot and fibers are separated by hand. The process of making yarn from fiber is called spinning. If we use our hands to spin yarn and make fabric, how long do you think it would take to make a small piece of fabric? To make yarn more efficiently, we use tools and machines. A quicker way to spin yarn is to use a thakli or hand spinning and a charaka or spinning wheel. Weaving. We will look at two different ways in which yarn is converted into fabric. This is the activity. Take a page from your notebook and divide it into long strips of paper. Weave the strips of paper, crossing strips one over the other to form a mat like this structure. Once the product is finished, you can cut off the extra piece of paper so where woven is together the yarn is woven together to make a piece of fabric to make the process of making fabric more efficient and fast we use machines called looms that is hand looms or power looms Weaving, the process of arranging two sets of yarns together to make a fabric is called weaving. A sweater is worn in cold weather. Have you ever wondered how a sweater is made? Sweaters are usually made by converting yarn to fabric through knitting. Knitting is done with the needles created especially for this purpose. So yarn is converted into fabric through weaving and knitting. History of clothing material. Have you ever wondered what materials people used in ancient times for clothes? It appears that in those times people used the bark and big leaves of trees or animal skins and furs to cover themselves. After people began to settle in agricultural communities, they learned to weave twigs and grass into mats and baskets. Animal fleece or hair were twisted together into long strands. These were woven into fabrics. The early Indians wore fabrics made out of cotton that grew in the regions near the river Ganga. Flax is also a plant that used natural fibers. In ancient Egypt, cotton as well as flax were cultivated near the river Nile and were used for making fabrics. In those days, stitching was not known. People simply wrapped the fabrics around different parts of their body. Many different ways of wrapping fabrics were used. With the invention of the sewing needle, people started stitching fabrics to make clothes. Just as there is a large variety in food eaten all over our country, a large variety exists also in fabrics and clothing items. Thank you.